Yeah.
And at the beginning, I was the
lovely.
Thank you.
I invite you all to stand for the bride and groom.
Thank you.
Welcome everyone to St. Luke's Church here in Flatbush. I'm Father Craig of the Parish Priest here. This is Deacon Tom from Australia. Never mind about that. But he's joining us today to celebrate this gift of love and life that you share with one another. So firstly, welcome to the two of you. It's because of your love that we've come out on a Saturday afternoon to celebrate with you. On their behalf, I extend a warm welcome to all of you. Now, you've been chosen out of everyone else that could have been chosen in Auckland to be here this afternoon. And you've been chosen because you have a connection with this couple, one way or another. But you have an important task this afternoon. It's not simply to look good and to enjoy your lunch. It's not what you're here for. Well, it's what you're here for, but not only. You are here to support this couple today and all the days of their life. Are you, their family and friends, happy to support and encourage them today and all the days of their life?
Yes.
All right. Are we really ready to support and encourage this couple all the days of their life?
Yes.
So when you enter into marriage, you don't do so alone. You do with the love and support of those gathered around you. Let's pray. Father, when you created humankind, you willed that man and wife should be one. Bind Shane and Maika in the loving union of marriage and make their love fruitful so that they may be living witnesses to your divine love in the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you all to be seated for our first reading.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond her pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and makes cloth with skillful hands. She puts her hands to the distaff and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches her hands out to the poor and extends her hands to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her reward of her labors and let her work praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To you in the silence. from the letters of Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, let mutual love continue. Do not neglect hospitality, for through it some have unknowingly entertained angels. Be mindful of prisoners as if sharing their imprisonment, and of all ill-treated as of yourselves, for you are also in the body. Let the marriage be honored among all, and the marriage bed be kept undefiled. Let your life be free from the love of money, but be content with what you have. Thus we may say with confidence, the Lord is my helper, and I will not be afraid. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate. The Gospel of the Lord.
The two shall become one. As we gather to celebrate today, there is a sense that we have two separate and unique individuals in our presence. You've had different backgrounds, different experiences which have led you here today. But in the sacrament of marriage, what you do is you let go of what it is to be single, and you embrace what it is to be one, to be a couple. It is really important that you continue to keep communicating with one another. Spending time, sharing stories, communicating. Because if you don't, you become what psychologists refer to today as married singles. There is such a term as married singles. Those who want to have the best of both worlds. They still want to have the benefits of being single, but also the benefits of what it is to be married. It doesn't work like that. You're called today to let go of what it is to be single and to embrace what it is to be married. Each of us is called to bring life and love into the world. That is the fundamental Christian vocation of us all, regardless of what state of life we share, whether we are soon to be married, whether we've been married for many years, whether we are single and hoping to be married, or whether we are celibate priests. Regardless of our state of life, the fundamental Christian vocation is to love, which is why in every Catholic church you will walk into, you will see a crucifix behind me in the window. It's a crucifix. It is different to a cross. A cross is two pieces of wood nailed together. A crucifix has a corpus or a corpse, Jesus' body on it. And we put it proudly right smack in front of you, right under your nose. You cannot miss it. And we do so for a reason, because that image, it's not an image to us of failure, of death, of destruction. For us as Christians, that is an image of selfless love, which is what each of us is called to. Very shortly, the two becoming one as husband and wife in the married state. You will be called to the cross, just as each of us is called to the cross, to love as God has loved us. And what it means, Shane, is that from here on in, everything you do is for Maika. Maika, I'd wipe that smile off your face. Because this is a two-way street. And from here on in, Maika, everything you do is for Shane. You live for one another. In fact, a couple I married donkeys years ago, many years ago, the husband said to me that my wife is my ticket to heaven. How I serve my wife and my family, how I live out that vocation of love, is how I'm getting to heaven. We assist each other, and I remind you of the importance of communicating with one another. But if you really want to let go of what it is to be single and embrace this married life and love as God has loved us, then we need to talk with them. We need to spend time communicating not just with each other, but with God. We call it prayer. And I really don't care how you pray, but I absolutely care that you pray. Because if we're called, each of us, whether we are married, whether we're single, whether we're a celibate priest, each of us, if we're called to love as Jesus loves us, we can't do it on our own efforts alone, and need to spend time communicating with that source of perfect love, which is God. And so I've challenged and invited every couple to spend some time each day in prayer, together. I don't know if it's been practice of yours up until today, but I encourage you from this day forward to spend 30 seconds, I'm not asking for hours, but 30 seconds a day in prayer, praying the Our Father. And I promise you that if you do, your married life will be better for doing it than for not doing it. And I'm not suggesting no magic words and they're going to make everything rosy and perfect. That's not true. But spending that time communicating with God will only help your marriage. So I encourage you to invest 30 seconds a day. Now, I'm not going to be with them in the years that unfold. You, your family and friends are. And I told you, you're here for a reason. And so I want you, you don't need to ask them for permission. I'm giving it to you today. Next time you see them, after today, whenever that might be, I want you to ask them, when was the last time you prayed the Our Father together? Encourage them, challenge them to spend 30 seconds a day, but clearly I'm not talking just to them. This is a message we all need to hear. If we all want to love selflessly, as God loves us, then all of us need to spend some time communicating with that source of perfect love. So, the two shall become one. If your faith makes you ready now to give yourselves to each other in marriage for the rest of your lives, I invite you to come and stand before God's altar. My dear friends, Shane and Maika, you've come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of me and Deacon Tom, the church's ministers, and this community, your family and your friends. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Maika and Shane, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
I have.
Will you love and honour each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
I will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
I will.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage and you have joined your hands, I now invite you to clear your consent before God and His church. I, Shane, take you Maika to be my wife.
I, Shane, take you Maika to be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Maika, take you, Shane, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you. All the days of my life. You both declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with His blessings. What God has joined together, no one must divide. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our world, may all lands that suffer violence and injustice find peace and reconciliation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, lonely, or depressed, may they be strengthened by God's love and aided by friends and family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the protection and
sanctity of human life, from conception until natural death. May all people be treated with the dignity they deserve as God's children. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Shane and Maika, may they live long, blessed live together, life together. May their love grow stronger each and every day. And may they build a family rooted in faith and unconditional love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We ask the Lord hear these prayers spoken on our behalf through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. As I pray the nuptial blessing over the couple now, I invite you in your own minds to say these words with me. Father, by your power you have made everything out of nothing. In the beginning you created the universe and made us in your own likeness. You gave man the constant help of woman, so that man and woman should no longer be two, but one flesh. And you teach us that what you have united may never be divided. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage, and let them be living examples of the Christian life. Give them the strength which comes from the Gospels, so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. Bless them with children, and help them to be good parents. May they live to see their children's children, and after a happy old age, grant them the fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you all to be seated as we now sign the marriage license. I invite the two witnesses to come forward.
Thank you.
pray that 30-second prayer that Christ has given us together for this cup of today. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Please welcome the new married couple of God.
I try not to be nervous, because I've done this before. Because I'm so happy, that's why I lost my voice the last 2 days, to let them know my excuses. Dear Father, dear Deacon Tom, and everybody, that's really Shane and Maika. A year ago, when my oldest son, Mary, I did share about the belief. And today, Father, Craig did comment about that again. Because it is important when you're married and you have children, without the belief, it's very hard, the struggle. And it happened in many families, especially even in my family or my mom and dad. Last time when I shared, Jenny and Nicole, Mary, and now my daughter, Maika and Shane, there were two candles, become one candle, is the life of a new life of a family. And I do believe that. I want to share a little story. It happened to me and my family many years ago. And that's why my marriage, my family, still strong today. After the Vietnam War, I don't think I've shared with my dad, but because some of my thing happened in my life, I don't usually share with my children. So I was about 15 years old. I never believed much in God or whatever. I didn't. During my escape after the war, I was a baby, my family, 12 children, siblings. My brother Tom is the oldest, I'm number 11. I left my brother and sister who escaped between 1979, I left 1982. During that time, my mother, my father in jail, and my mother prayed every night. I slept with her so I knew about 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock in the morning, every night, so that my brother and sister could escape safely. I don't share that many stories, but because of survival, and because of marriage, because of my daughter, and the only daughter, and the only my only son-in-law, I need to share today. So during my 7 days on the boat, without water and food, if you watch a movie called The Perfect Storm, they are lucky, they not survive. I was on top of it, and nothing to cling on. I was there, the world up there. I watched a book of Perfect Storm for more than 10 times. My wife doesn't understand why I'm watching it. And I didn't know how to survive. I was unconscious on top of it. I didn't know why I was falling off. We don't have much time to share you a true story. I went unconscious. In the morning after the storm, I saw the lady. She was on top of it. The rest was under, holding the baby, and she was crying. When I opened my eye, It was a frosty, and so I didn't know. The first thing I look at her, I remember my mother. My mother prayed for me because she believed in it. She believed that all of my eight brothers and sisters who survived at that those time. In my marriage, would I have believed I probably wouldn't survive? Now, 30 years marriage, my daughter, today 28, she's very competitive. When I married 28, she tried to marry 28. Jamie married 28, she tried to marry 28 years old. She bought a house before what? She bought a house before I was 28. So she can pick everything. I'm very proud of her. She does many things in my family. She supports the whole family in many ways, including the two boys as well. So I'm very proud of her today. I want to share two things with you, Shane and Maika. Apart from belief, there are two things in marriage. You need to remember and move fast, and there's a patience and loving. Without believing, and you don't have patience, thing will blow up. Loving because of family. So you take those two with you, including the belief when your brother married last year. I know Shane is a loving young man. Maika, she is a brother, very generous. You will see it tonight, this afternoon. She's very generous. And when you go to the party, you will see it. I don't want to spend too much time talking, but I would like to thank you so much, all of you being here with my family. I always believe when you pray for somebody, they got to think about 3 to 10 times, like you pray for yourself. And I do just that. I've done it, and I've seen it. So thank you so much. I'd just like to remind, we're going to have a party lunch after this. Just before that, we're going to take some photo. I'm not sure what time is it now, but... So after this, we go straight to restaurant, but before that, we're going to take a couple of photos. We would like to ask our Father Craig and Deacon Tom to take a photo first, and then a family from Maika and Shane. And then if anybody would like to take a photo, please do so. And then we go straight to the restaurant. And I'm sure you all know your table at the restaurant. And I look forward to seeing you. I hope you enjoy it tonight. Thank you so much. And so we'll see you here. We would like to invite a Shane's family, please. And then after that, because we don't have much time, we're going to take either a photo here or the restaurant. So if you'd like to take a photo here, please come up here ready. So we just line up and do it quickly. Shane's family, please.
Does anyone like take a photo with the bridal group? Please come up. We'll be leaving here in 10 minutes.
Shirt.
Oh shit.
Oh, what is that?
Oh my god.